start, can I welcome everybody to this meeting of the Cabinet. Particularly pleased to see so many members of the public, so welcome everybody. Just got a few preliminary items to deal with before we go into the main business. Item number one is the Members' Code of Conduct Declaration of Interest. Do any members of the Cabinet wish to declare any interests? Bernie? Thanks for that. So we're now going to go into a couple of reports. I mean, I think there's a number of members of the public here, and for some of these items. But we're going to do two items. First item is we're going to have a presentation around the success of the Open Championship 2014 to 2003. And then we'll go straight into the outcome of future council budget options. So people, please bear with us. We've got a team of people here to talk about the Open Championship. We've travelled quite a lengthy distance, so I'm keen that we have them on first. Can I just say a few words by way of introduction to this before I introduce our guests? You know, the Open Championship was, I think, a fantastic spectacle for Wirral and for the Liverpool City region. Generated a huge amount of interest and a lot of media attention. And I think it was a really great advert for the borough and a great advert for the region. However, I think we were very keen to try and capture particularly the economic benefits of of having the tournament in Wirral. And to that end, we've got some colleagues here tonight who were played a big part in the success of the Open Championship 2014, and hopefully that will continue in future years, and hopefully we'll get the Open back to Wirral in the near future. So I'd just like to introduce our guests who are here tonight to take us through this presentation. We've got John Gorry from the Royal and Ancient. John, very welcome. Max Gilliam from RepiCon, and Professor Simon Shipley, who works at the Sports Industry Research Centre at Sheffield Hallam University, who've done the analysis around the economic benefit. So can I welcome our three guests, very grateful to you for coming to the town hall tonight. And without further ado, can I hand over to you to take us through the presentation?
Thank you, John.
Thank you, John.
Thank you very much, Leader, councillors, ladies and gentlemen. Cast your minds back to July. The Open Championship at Royal Liverpool Golf Club attracted over 200,000 spectators to the week-long event. And what we're here to talk about this evening is the impact that that event, the championship, had in the 1 week that it was here. So the economic benefit that came to this part of the world, both to geographies, to the world and to the wider Northwest from that 1 week. And then also to look at the value of the exposure that the championship manages to grip the golf fans around the world with. In that the Open is seen by millions and millions of people around the world, in fact over 500 million people fall within the reach of the Open Championship around the world. So I've got a couple of people with me today. The first person I'll introduce you to is Max exposure of Wirral and the wider Northwest on television, particularly on television, although in other media, but particularly on television around the world. So Max, one thing, apologies from the RNA's director of championship, Johnny Paul Hamilton, who would love to have been here this evening. Unfortunately, he has a prior engagement, which he couldn't play this evening. So, Max.
Thank you, Chair.
Thank you.
Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Chair.
Okay, so, yep, as John said, my name's Max, I'm from a company called Repcon, and our job was to assess the economic impact of the Wirral at the Open Championship. I'm just going to talk briefly about our objectives, the approach in which we came across generating the economic analysis, and the ultimate findings. We at Repcon, we analysed the media value across TV, TV news, print and online. The benefit was to ultimately see what the exposure to the world was and to look at it across all of these medium types as to how it benefited economically. So we monitored numerous brands associated with the Wirral and the Open Championship. This included Royal Liverpool, Wirral, host of the Open Championship, so on and so forth. And we looked at it across live TV exposure of the event, as well as TV news and other dedicated programming. So at Repcon, what we do is we generate two different valuations. First of all, we have 100% media value. What this means is we look at every single brand exposure as if it was taking up the whole screen, for example. That is what we call 100%. But we also focus on something called QI media value. So here we take into account the size of each brand exposure, the location on the screen, number of seconds in which it's been present, and the number of brand hits. The same applies for print and online. We also generate a QI media value. Again, similar variables. We look at the size of the brand exposure, the location in which it's present, so whereabouts it's positioned in the print article or on the website, how clear it is, and the number of brand hits at any given time. Here's just an example of the two different valuations. As I say, we do 100% in QI. Our 100% media value assumes that the brand is present across the whole of the screen or different medium type. QI media value, on the other hand, takes into account its position and its clarity, and as I say, the other aspects of all of the criteria. So, ultimately, when looking at it on a QI media value basis, across all four platforms, we recognise that the Wirral and all of its associated brands generate a QI media value of 23p. For TV, the QI media value was 17.4 and the 100% media value was 52.2p. TV news generated a QI media value of 60,000 and 100% media value of 225,000. Print, £648,000, and online, 4.9 QI media value. This is a global valuation, it's not UK orientated. So, from TV, we found that the postcard shots were the some of the best generating value hits for the Wirral. What postcard shots are is when the TV crew will take a panorama over their local area, and we will value that at 100%. We will also take into account every single 70% of the overall value came from ESPN and ESPN2 in the US. Overall, the QI media value in this particular media type was £60,000. Royal Liverpool Golf Club was the highest value brand, and Hoy Lake was the next highest. Likewise for print, the New York Daily Times, sorry, the New York Daily News generated £70,000 in QI media value. Both the New York Times and Daily Telegraph had the largest numbers of brand mentions. The Daily Mail produced the largest value for the UK market. Online, Yahoo.com generated £1.5 million in QI media value. There were 750 mentions of the Wirral branding and had the highest number of daily users. The next highest was the Telegraph. So,
probably a little bamboozling all the facts and figures, but if you are a major corporate sponsor, if you're a Mercedes-Benz or Rolex or HSBC, and you put money into sponsoring an event like the Open Championship, that's the sort of detail that you want back to show that your money is well spent. And what the Open is delighted to be able to do and to say is that because of the great help that we get in staging the event in the world, we're delighted that the Open puts back into the local community. It puts back in terms of a direct economic impact, which Simon's just about to talk about. But this, the value of the exposure of Wirral and the wider Northwest to a television audience around the world means that people will keep on coming back here. So the fantastic golf courses that you've got in this part of the world, golf tourism gets this boost, it gets this multi-million pound boost from the event being here. And I know it seems like a lot of detail, but that's the detail if you are putting millions of pounds in and you're a bank or you're a car company, that's the sort of detail that you need. So I apologise for presenting you with a lot of it this evening, but I hope you take from that that you're getting a lot of that. Simon.
Good evening, everyone. It's a real pleasure to be here. I really enjoy coming and presenting to local people the results of an economic impact study. I've done similar things at the London Marathon, Wimbledon, when we just completed the Ryder Cup. So we're quite experienced at doing this sort of thing, and hopefully that will give you a really simple message as to what the event has been worth. We were asked to look at the economic impact on two areas of geography. First of all, the Wirral borough area, and secondly, the Old and Northwest. So what we're really interested in is new money coming into the economy that would not have come had it not been for the Open Championship taking place. Thank you. important thing is spectators. So that's why we interviewed some 3,000 of them, which is a massive piece of work. And you can see spectators just under 9 million in Wirral and just over 9 million on the northwest. The other groups, like the players and their entourages, the media, the event staff, we've been doing this now for 5 years. Where these people come from, how much they spend, how many people come in their baskets. So the direct impact to Wirral is 3.45 million. And as is conventional with economic impact studies, we apply a multiplier to this figure. And a multiplier of 1.31, that's where we get the 19 million from. So we can audit that there was 14.45 million cash actually spent in Wirral, and then when you allow for that recirculating amongst businesses and the supply chain, that's the equivalent of 19 million. And we do the same for the Northwest. The cash inflow, if you like, is 15.48 million. Apply a modest multiplier to reach the level, and you get some community multipliers of 2 and 3, and 1.3 is quite prudent. And that's what gives you 24.1 million. That's it. So just remember those figures: 19 million for Wirral, 24 for the northwest region, 34,000 total for the nights, about 70,000 for the region as a whole. Those are the takeaway messages.
I think if you think back to what Matt was saying about the value of the Open Championship on television, one figure he mentioned was 52 million. And then if you think of what Simon's saying about the value to the Northwest being about 25 million, I think what World Council will be announcing tomorrow, and if you're hearing it first, is that the economic benefit, if you want to look at the two together, is in excess of 75 million from that 1 week. Championship being in this part of the world. The Open, of course, is played on 9 Seaside Links courses around the UK. It's next in this part of the world in, I think, 2017 when it's back at Royal Birkfield. It's not been announced when it will be next back at Royal Liverpool, but if you look back at the history of the event, it would be a fairly safe bet to say that it will be back at some point. When it comes back, it will be looking slightly different. This is, in fact, the oldest major championship in the world, and it's the only of the 4 major championships in the world. It's the only one that's not played in America. It's the only one that's played in the US. So it's just gone through a very big brand makeover. This is what it now looks like. This is the one where it all began, and there's a very, very short little bit of film that explains some of the thinking that's gone into the economy. So, say it looked different, but we very much look forward to coming back to this part of the world. Thank you.
Thanks, John. Thanks very much. Thanks. Okay, I think that was a really positive kind of report back. Questions from camera members? Can I ask? I mean, just out of interest, how does the recent Open in Wirral and the benefits that you explained compare to previous talks in terms of?
Yeah, the RNA select the 9 venues on the router. They go because they go to those venues because they present the best challenge to the players. And we're talking about heritage and pedigree of the event. So all of that comes first, and the money comes second. Some championship venues attract much fewer spectators. So maybe as few as 150,000, 160,000 at some venues. St Andrews is always the biggest, the home of golf. It's attracted to 250,000 spectators. And I think as Simon was pointing out, it's the spectators that count. They're the ones that deliver the greatest amount of economic impact. So the greater the number of spectators, the bigger the financial number. St Andrews is always biggest, or has always been biggest. Second to that has been Wirral. The last time we were